Hey, what's up everyone? Mack Murdoc here with OPT, and today I'm gonna tell you all about the Radian Focuser. Taking apart and dismantling your telescope to install one of these could sound pretty scary, especially if you haven't done it before. But don't worry, I got your back. It's a lot less scary and much easier than you may think. But first, if you appreciate these videos and all the info that goes into them, please consider smashing the like button. Every time you smash the like button, a beautiful baby dragon is born. Aww, aren't you so cute? Anyways, so this is the Radian Focuser. This focuser is a super high precision electronic focuser that will help keep your images super sharp throughout the night. Having an electronic focuser helps take away from the guessing on where the perfect focus is by using algorithms to find the point in which your stars are the smallest. Different things like weather, filter changes, slight slippage of the draw tube, and even how high your target is off the horizon can slightly change the focus. So it's good to refocus a couple times throughout the night for best results. With an electronic focuser like the Radian Focuser, you don't have to think about it. Just set it and forget it. And with the Radian Focuser, this is all you need. No need for a bulky box or a separate hand controller. Just install this, plug it in, download the drivers, and you're ready to rock. This focuser can fit on any feather touch 2.5, 2.7, and 3 inches wide. The Radian Focuser has something really special about it that's different from most other focusers, so stick around to the end to find out what that is. So all right, let's get this installed. So let's grab our Raptor and take everything out of the box. We got our cable and our hex keys. And obviously the focuser is in the box. So the first step of installing this is to take off the original focus knobs. It's super easy. Just stick in the mid-size key into the hole on the focus knob and unscrew. And remove. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Now don't forget to put these in a safe place and not to lose them, because you never know when you might need to use them again. Okay, the next step is very important, and you gotta get this right. And that is smashing that like button if you haven't already. Nah, but grab your Radian Focuser and slide it onto the metal bracket. It might go on with ease the first time, or you might have to loosen the screw with the included hex key to fit around the metal bracket. And you might need to loosen the screw so it can fit inside this hole. Once it's on, tighten the large screw down, then tighten the small one to firmly attach it to the pin. And just like that, you've installed the Radian Focuser. See, not too bad, right? All right, now let's use the included cables to plug it in, give it power, and let's set up the drivers. We've included a power cable in there, but any 12 volt 2.1 by 5.5 millimeter power plug should work. And any standard USB cable will work as well to connect it to your computer. So first we want to install the correct drivers. So head on over to Ascom and download their latest driver. And don't worry, I'll put all the links for you down in the description so you know exactly where to go. You know me. Always trying to make things easier for you. After that, you want to head on over to our Radian Telescopes website, click the Raptor rundown at the top, and after you're done enjoying that familiar face, scroll on down to the Radian Focus drivers. I'm using Windows, so I'm going to download that driver, but this focuser can also work on Mac, Linux, and Raspberry Pi devices. And once that's downloaded, you can open it up, click connect, and you're all ready to go. You may have to go into the settings and find the correct COM port that it's connected to, and then you hit connect. To come back to the main screen, just hit Radian. Now, if you want to move the focuser in and out, you just click in and out. And if you want to move it more dramatically, just increase the number. And if you want more of a fine focus, you just decrease this number. And after this, you should be able to connect your focuser to all your favorite sequencing softwares like SGP, APT, Nina, Prism, and so many more. And then program it to focus automatically whenever you want. I should note though, unfortunately, at this current moment, you cannot use it with the ASI Air. Now, what's that cool thing that I mentioned right in the beginning that's different from most other focusers? Well, it's this right here. This motor actually turns to engage and disengage the focuser, allowing you to either use the focuser or manually focus it for any reason. Sometimes I'll manually focus on the moon or the sun where I get it pretty close and then lock in the focuser and then do the fine tuning on the computer. You never know, but it's a great option to have. Anyways, that's all you need to know about the Radian Focuser. If you have any questions at all, don't hesitate to reach out. And if you have any suggestions for videos that you want to see, leave it in the comments below. I actually read every one of them. Anyways, that about wraps it up for me. My name is Mack Murdoc, here with OPT, and thanks for watching. Clear skies.